After doing git pull or even git merge, this is the result. All those weird markers are spread across the file. But how can Visual Studio Code help us solve this merge conflict? As you can see, there are these buttons on top of each conflict block, and this is the old merge conflict UI. From version 1.70, you also have this Resolve in Merge Editor button that opens the three-way editor. Anyway, I'm going to show you both, so you can decide which one you want to use. In the text-based view, as you can see, there are two sections. One is green and is the code that is coming from your own branch, as it say current change, while the blue section is the incoming change, that is the code coming from the other branch, or if you just did git pull, and this is the remote branch you're pulling from. You can find here accept current change or incoming change, that as you may guess, will basically remove everything else but what you just selected. For example, if I do that again, accept current change will keep received data. Now, if you want to accept both changes for whatever reason, you can click accept both and there it is, you have both, one next to the other. You also have this fourth button over here that is compare changes. This will open the compare change window that will show on the same line what is gonna change. In this case, let me accept the current change and go to the next merge conflict that you can see from the bar over here. If I scroll down, there it is. This one is a little bit bigger because two methods have been added. How can I handle this? Well, let's say you want to add both changes because those are two functions you want to keep, but here you can see that it's actually not compiling, and this is basically the main reason why I like to fix conflicts on VS Code, because if you do that on a separate editor, you might miss things like this one. So as I'm already in the editor, I can super easy make sure that the code works by adding this bracket and semicolon over here. Now, you can find in the source control tab that there are two files with conflicts. As you can see, the files with the exclamation mark over here. So now that I fixed API, I can move over to fetch. Here is the same situation. So let's say I want to keep both changes for the purpose of this video, and I can save the file. To be honest, I like this simple text-based UI, but let me also show you this other version that was introduced a couple months ago, that is the three-way merge editor. If you want to enable the three-way editor by default, you can go in the settings, type merge editor, and make sure to tick this box over here. When this is ticked, from the source control tab, if you just select a file, it will automatically open the three-way editor, that is basically the same you can do by clicking Resolve in Merge Editor. As you can see here, instead of having two inline sections as we had in the text-based editor, you can find an entire section over here with all the incoming file, another section on the right with the current change. Make sure to not get confused, because previously we saw that on top you had the current change, while here the current change is on the right and not on the left. And you have this third panel over here, that is the final result, as you can see from this label over here. Now we can do pretty much the same operations, for example accepting the incoming or the current. The difference is now that you have the button on the respective section. So if I hit accept incoming, I will see in the final result here that the incoming change has been selected. I can handily remove from here and grab accept current from the other section. Obviously, if I want both, I can accept combination. This is a little bit weird because I would have expected them to be on different lines, but once again, since I'm doing these changes directly on the editor, it's super easy to make it up and fix whatever error it might find. One more handy feature of the three-way editor is this button over here that says how many conflicts are remaining, and as you can see from the label, if you click it, it will bring you to the next conflict. This is a little bit weird because you cannot see at first, but let me fix the UI a little bit. So this is the same example as before, so we have two new functions that are overlapping in the same lines. If you want to ignore one of them, you have this ignore button over here. If you want to accept both, you can accept a combination. In this case, as you can see, it's been smart enough to make sure the semicolon is here and the closing bracket so that the code can actually compile. As soon as you're ready, you can hit complete merge and the file will be already set in the state changes. You can do the same for the other file, let's say accept current, complete merge, And there it is, you're actually ready to continue your merge. When finally all conflicts are resolved, regardless if you use the text-based or the three-way, you can continue your merge simply in the VS Code editor. If you did your changes from the three-way editor, you will find your files already in the state changes, that are the files that are ready to be committed. Otherwise, if you did that from the text-based UI, the situation will be something like this. The files that previously had conflicts are still here with the exclamation mark in the merge changes section. You can either add them one by one from this plus icon over here, or use this one to stage all merge changes. In the unfortunate case of your codebase being so damaged, don't worry, you can reset the merge and start everything from scratch. To be honest, I haven't found this feature directly in the UI, but you can do so from the quick pick menu with the option Abort Merge. With this option, your codebase will be as clean as before the merge, and you can either try again or go ahead and keep working in your branch. So, what do you think? Can this UI be improved for a better handling of merge conflicts? Well, it's your lucky day, because you have the power to do so. As you might know, Visual Studio Code is open source, which means you can create a pull request, and if the Microsoft team decides to accept your code, well, congratulations, you contributed to VS Code for everyone in the world. Now, I have this video over here where I show you how this process works and how can you merge code on the Microsoft repository. You should have a look and see you there.